Hey, Arch people.
Moki's out here. I'm cleaning. I haven't seen a little rabbit this morning. And I'm telling where he's hiding in. So I don't know if I'm going to post this before or after, because sometimes I put these videos and I post the one afterwards. So if you already saw the video on where I did all this, then you know what's going on. But if you don't, you'll know when I post it. So this was sitting out here in the sun, kind of getting sunbeat, and it was really dirty. They don't come with these holes drilled in the bottom. I drilled some holes in it so it would drain. But the problem with drilling holes is sometimes the grain or something fall through too a little bit. But it's not the end of the world. So I don't know if I'm going to leave this way or will I put it vertical. It depends on how the horses come in here and stand. Okay, so I don't know why it just cut off there. I'll add it in. So anyway, you can tell this over time gets kind of the horses lick, they slobber. Sometimes I pour some red cell in here so that sticks. So over time these get pretty dirty. So I got some simple grain there and a little brush. I'm just gonna hose it down and scrub it, and then I'll put it back where they normally eat over there. And then in the winter, if I want to put some hay in there and they come snack, it'll keep it out of the rain and stuff. And then this will still be for their grain. But I bought this second one, or initially I was going to give it to a Mustang rescue. And like most rescues, all they do is want money. And they always say they need help and they want help. And then somebody from my channel usually says, oh, this is a really great rescue and you should really go try and help and you could be really helpful. And I go and I volunteer my services and I don't hear back. And I think Inspired Clips sent me something up in Bowie, Texas, just north of me up here. They do good work. They need your help, blah, blah, blah. Please contact them. You know, it just, people wonder why people in horse business just start ignoring other horse people. Is most of them are freaking scatterbrained. And, you know, these rescue women, it's just, I don't know what it is about rescue women that it's something so empty in their life that they have to fill it with a bunch of things to keep busy. And then they run around and say how busy they are, which gives them an excuse to neglect everything else in their life, to neglect the things that they've taken on responsibility for, but they just keep wanting to rescue and take on more, and then that gives them an excuse to ignore everything else. But, you know, I called this Bowie place, I give them my email, I say, look, if you want to come into a clinic, help you with a difficult horse, maybe teach a horse trailer, whatever. They don't call back. You know, it's just a waste of my freaking time, and I know that the people that send me that mean well, but I am telling you, years and years of dealing with rescue women and rescue horse people, they just hi Moki. it's just something missing. It's not only rescues, it's the same people that rescue dogs or cats. It's just something, I don't know what the void they're trying to fill by having a bunch of kids, a bunch of dogs, a bunch of people. I gotta fill my life with busy so I can always say I'm busy so my life feels full. Meanwhile, it's fucking empty and everything in their life just suffers and they just keep on taking more. I gotta do this, I gotta do this. I don't get it. But anyway, that rescue kind of, you know, another thing on my list to say, stop trying to help these freaking crazy rescue places. All they want is money and it's just BS. So anyway, that's my little rant on that. I had some food out here for Stewie and his little rabbit friends, but I don't know where the hell they're at. Drinking my coffee. Let's see if little Stewie's back here. I'll take you around, see the boys are finishing up their breakfast anyway. Let's see if that crazy rabbit's in here. Oh, yeah, I think I see his little butt way back there. I don't know if you guys can see him. He's under that little shed I put back there. So I have to go get him some. Oh, there's the boys. They came around. They were hurrying. Okay, let's see if Buddy notices that his feed bucket is gone. What are you boys doing? Oh, you lazy critters. Rick, you should get more horses, and you should get more cats, and you should rescue and save, and then you... every time you add something to your life, you take away of everything else in your life. I don't get when women are going to figure that out. And I'm sure there's guys that do it. I haven't met any crazy guy rescue people that have to take on more and always running around how busy they are. And why are you crying? I just cleaned the. Come on up here and get your little pets. Come on, you know where to get up here. Don't act like you don't know. Get your butt up here. Come on. Come on. All right, let me set him up. I got to move him over here. Now turn around. Come on. Come on. Oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness. A bunch of little pets on YouTube. Oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness. All right, so I got to finish scrubbing this, and maybe I'll do a before and after. So this is before. I'll do an after. All right, I had my two helpers helping me out the whole time. It's nice and clean, good as new. I'll bring it back in there. And now the horses have a nice little clean area, and I'll clean again in another 6 months or so, maybe after the winter. So that's clean. That's another little tip that I figured out is this north side of my wall, after they put this thing up, had mold, and my paint on there was like really looking dingy and moldy. I can't find it anywhere else. It's only on this north wall. And in Texas, anything that faces the north, you're going to get a little mold, or you can actually see it at the top. It looks like I didn't get it real good. So I can tell, oh shit, I can show you what this whole wall looked like. So you see that? I didn't scrub that real good because I used a broom. But this whole wall looked like that. And so what I did is I just sprayed Simple Green on it, and I took a broom, a soft bristle, like the big push broom that you have, and I just scrubbed it with a push broom up and down and rinsed it. And I removed. Now hopefully, so it won't be getting this moisture all the time, the mold will go away, but you can tell where the broom did not really remove it all at the top there. So if you want to remove that, I could probably get up there and scrub it, but it's not that big of a deal. It just looked really bad down below. And since the horse is going to be hanging out there, I didn't want them breathing or having that little mold down here. So I said, what the hell, I'll just clean it. So if I really get motivated, which is probably slim to none and slim left town, I will get up there and scrub these corners. So anyway, and the horses, I did find one poop in here. Horses like to come in new areas and poop. I don't know what it is. Some people say it's a stud pile, or you know, studs will usually mark their areas, their corners of their area, where they'll always poop in the same area. So anybody coming in will smell it and see it. But I think horses just like to poop in places they've been, make them feel a little safe. So that's my projects for today. Oh, I don't even know what day it is. I think it's Wednesday. A little Moki cat helping me. I'll go feed the rabbit. I got to fill up the bird bath, because I hose that down. And then maybe I'll head to the gym. Or maybe I won't. We'll see how I feel. All right. Buddy, Mr. T. Our buddy and Ransom and Mr. T. You're good boys. They're like, whatever, dude. Buddy, you still think about old Mr. T? Do you? I do too. I miss the old man. I know. All right. Well, a note there. I don't see them drinking together a lot. Usually Ransom waits. So to see them both taking a drink at the same time is he's going to lead them back out to the back. So they have their snack. It's the morning sun. And after they have their little snack,
Ransom seems to be walking pretty good. I did his feet last week. I thought he might be a little sore, but he actually seems like he's doing pretty good. So Buddy's going to be hightailing it. Hi, Little Mocap. Why are you stalking your dad? Why are you treating me like a bird you're trying to sneak up on? Oh, Buddy stopped to eat. Normally, after they have their breakfast, they go straight back out to that back area out there and stand in the shade.
All right. I'll add this in somewhere.